Siobhan, in this tutorial I am going to talk about arithmetic operators, and as you know, in mathematics we have plus, minus, multiplication, which is the star, and division, which is the slash. And in C, additional operators are reminder after division. We have increment, we have decrement, we have plus equal, minus equal, we have multiple equal, and we have division equal. And also we have remind equal. Now I am going to write a very simple program. Main int, main void, declare two variables, int I equal 73 and j equal 49, and I am going to print f d new line, d new line, d new line, d, it's 4, a new line, it's 4 1 2 3 4, and I am going to write I plus j, I minus j, I multiply by j, and I divided by j. Return 0, because our function main has a type integer, I return an integer which is 0. And I have defined two integer values, and I have initialized them. I is 73 and j is 49. And in memory, you have created a memory named J, which has value 73, and another memory which is called J, and it has value 49. Now I am going to run this program, and as you see, I plus j is 122. The difference between them is 24. Multiplication is 3577, and the division is 1. Okay, now I am going to write calculate the remainder of them, and I am going to use the plus plus I and j plus plus. I am going to show you the difference between the prefix of plus plus incrementing and prefix plus plus or prefix increment of j, and I am going to show you what is there. Okay, as you see, I divided by j is 1, and the remainder of the difference of these two, which is 24, the remainder is 24. Now I am going to see, when I use increment as prefix, it's going to increment I value with 1 and put it in I directly. But when I am going to use as suffix, it's going to increment J with one, but it keep it in the memory and it doesn't put it directly in J. And J has a value 49 yet. But when I am writing J again, then it is the has a value 50 when I call J again after that, then it has a value 50. And I am going to use another functions. I am going to use I plus equal J is the same as I equal I plus J, and J minus equal I is the same as J equal J minus I. As you see here, we have incremented I with J. We have put in I 73 plus 49, which is 122. And in another way, we have increment J, which is 49 yet, with 122, it's I's new value. We have used 49 minus 122, which is minus 73. When I run this this one, I and J, now you can see that it is 122 and minus 73, as we saw. Now I am going to use multiple, and I am going to use division, and I multiple by J. I multiple equal J is the same as I equal I multiple by J, and J divided equal I, it is as the same as J equal J divided by I. And I multiple by J is 73 multiplied by 49, which is 3577, as we saw before. And J, which is 49 yet, divided by the I's new value, which is 3577, it is 0. It's J is very shorter than the new value of I, and it is 0. And I am going to use okay, we run this, and it is what we suggested. The multiplication is 3577 and the division is 0. And I am going to use a simply I remind reminded by remind equal g, which means that I equal I reminded by j reminded by j after division, and I am going to only write the value of I. Which is 24, as we have seen before. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.